Hi dear students, from the equivalent concept, in this video we will learn about equivalent weight of an element, equivalent weight of salt, equivalent weight of acids and bases. Let us start this video with the equivalent weight of elements. This is from the chapter some basic concepts of chemistry, right? This is a 11th part. From the equivalent concept is known as refinement of mole concept, because no equation is needed when we are doing the calculations based on the equivalent concept. Using the equivalent concept, when stoichiometric calculations are done, no equation is required, right? Let us start our discussion with the equivalent weight or the equivalent mass of an element. Which is defined as mass of an element which combines with or displaces one part of hydrogen or eight parts of oxygen or 35.5 parts of chlorine by mass. Students, the equivalent weight of hydrogen, it is fixed. One. Equivalent weight of oxygen is 8. Equivalent weight of chlorine, it is 35.5. So equivalent weight of other elements are defined based on the equivalent weight of hydrogen or with the oxygen or chlorine, right? Mass of an element which combines with or displaces one part of hydrogen or 8 parts of oxygen or 35.5 parts of chlorine by mass, that is known as equivalent weight of an element. For example, students, zinc reaction will take. Zinc is reacted with the dilute sulfuric acid to give zinc sulfate ZnSO4 plus H2, right? This itself, it is a balanced equation, right? So in this case, 1 mole of zinc is giving 1 mole of H2, right? So 1 mole of zinc mass is 65.3 grams, because atomic mass of zinc is 65.3, right? 65.3 grams of zinc is giving 1 mole of H2. 1 mole of H2 weight is 2 grams. Then how much zinc will give 1 gram of hydrogen? Okay, this is a displacement reaction. In this reaction, the equivalent weight of an element is defined as the weight or the mass of an element which displaces 1 gram of hydrogen, one part of hydrogen by mass. 2 grams of hydrogen is displaced by 65.3 grams. 1 gram of H2 is displaced by 65.3 divided by 2. That is 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4, right? 2 6s are 2 5s are, right? 32.65 is the equivalent weight of the zinc. Equivalent weight of the zinc is 32.65. If the equivalent weight is expressed in grams, then that is called as a gram equivalent weight, gram equivalent weight of zinc is equal to 32.65 grams. Equivalent weight expressed in the grams, that is called as a gram equivalent weight, right? Students, let us take one simple question. Let us take one simple question. 74.5 grams of metal chloride contains 35.5 grams of chlorine. 35.5 grams of chlorine. Then what is the equivalent weight? What is the equivalent weight of metal oxide? Metal oxide. Students, question it is given as 74.5 grams of metal chloride contains 35.5 grams of chlorine. Then what is the equivalent weight of the metal oxide? For example, E is the equivalent weight of the metal. Then equivalent weight of metal oxide is equivalent weight of the metal plus oxygen equivalent weight, that is 8, right? Equivalent weight of metal chloride, that is equivalent weight of metal plus chlorine equivalent weight, that is a 35.5. Students, here the weight of metal chloride is equal to 74.5 grams. Then weight of metal is equal to weight of the metal chloride minus weight of the chlorine. This how much you will get? This is 39 grams we are getting, right? So straight away the weight of the metal, what we got, 39 grams, it is the gram equivalent weight of the metal, because here directly that is the 39 grams of the metal is combining with the 35.5 grams of the chlorine, which is same as a gram equivalent weight of the chlorine. So the metal equivalent weight, that is 39. Here 39 grams of metal is combining with 35.5 grams of chlorine. So 39 itself, it is equivalent weight of metal. Students, then equivalent weight of the metal is 39 plus oxygen equivalent weight. 39 plus 8, that is a 47. If they are asking about the gram equivalent weight of the metal oxide, then 47 grams, right? Next, let us discuss about the equivalent weight of salts. Students, next is equivalent weight of salt. Equivalent weight of the salt is molecular weight divided by positive or negative valency. Equivalent weight of salt is equal to molecular weight divided by positive or negative valency. Students, for example, if it is CuSO4, charge on the Cu is +2, charge on the sulfate is -2, right? Then if the molecular weight of CuSO4 is capital M, then equivalent weight will be molecular weight divided by either this 2 or this 2, we can take, right? Positive or negative valency. M by 2, equivalent weight of CuSO4 is M by 2. If it is AlCl3, AlS +3 and 3ClS -3 charge, then equivalent weight is equal to molecular mass, if it is M, divided by its positive or negative valency. 3 we can take. Okay, so in this method we can calculate the equivalent weight of the salt. Let us take one more question, students, let us take one more question. 5.25 grams of metal carbonate on heating gives 2.5 grams of metal oxide. Find out the equivalent weight of metal. Students, generally when we are using the equivalent concept, no equation is required. But anyway, we don't know what is the metal, okay, then we don't know what is the formula of metal oxide also, what is the valency of the metal also here, right? Then generally it is a metal carbonate. I am writing it as a metal carbonate. Formula we don't know. On heating it is giving metal oxide. We are using equivalent concept. When we are using equivalent concept, students, we can write it as, this is general sentence for all the questions in which we are using the equivalent concept, that is number of gram equivalents of reactant is equal to number of gram equivalents of product. But in the mole concept, we cannot write it as a number of moles of the reactants is equal to number of moles of the products. We cannot write, but equivalent concept we can write. So for example, if we take an acid base reaction, acid plus base gives rise to salt plus water. So when we are using the mole concept, unless until it is a balanced equation, we cannot tell how many moles of acid is involved, how many moles of the base is involved. But equivalent concept we can write it as number of gram equivalents of acid is the same as a number of gram equivalents of the base. But we know that molecular weights are constant, but gram equivalent weights we have to consider when we are calculating the gram, number of gram equivalents, right? So here later we will discuss in detail about acid base titrations. In this question, the reactant is metal carbonate. Number of gram equivalents of the metal carbonate is equal to number of gram equivalents of the product, that is a metal oxide. Assume equivalent weight of metal as capital E. Students, for the number of gram equivalents of the carbonate, is number of gram equivalents formula is 5.25 divided by the equivalent weight of the carbonate. Metal equivalent weight plus carbonate equivalent weight is 30, because carbonate CO3 2 minus, the mass of carbonate, that is 3 × 16 + 12, that we will get it as a 60, divided by equivalent weight of the carbonate is 60 divided by its valency, 30 we are getting. So the weight of metal carbonate divided by equivalent weight of metal carbonate is equivalent weight of the metal plus carbonate equivalent weight, that is 30. 60 divided by its valency, mass is 60, 12 + 48, 60 divided by 2 is 30, which is same as number of gram equivalents of the metal oxide, right? Metal oxide, how much they have given it as 2.5 divided by E plus the equivalent weight of the metal oxide is equivalent weight of the metal plus oxygen equivalent weight. Do the cross multiplication, that is 2.5 × E plus 30 × 2.5 is equal to 5.25 E plus 5.25 × 8. Okay, on simplifying this, students, we will get equivalent weight of the metal E is equal to 12. If it is a gram equivalent weight, of metal, we will get it as a 12 grams, right? Next, let us discuss about the equivalent weight of acid. Students, next is equivalent weight of acid. Equivalent weight of acid is molecular weight of acid, divided by basicity. Basicity for acid, it is also known as valence factor or N factor. Earlier, when we have discussed about the CuSO4, equivalent weight of CuSO4, that molecular mass divided by valency we are putting, that is 2. That 2 is known as valence factor or N factor. For an acid, valence factor or N factor is basicity. Basicity is number of replaceable hydrogen atoms in an acid. Okay, for example, if we take a sulfuric acid, H2SO4, structure will be sulfur is the central atom, double bond O, OH, OH, right? This has two OH groups, that is the same as a basicity. The hydrogen atoms which are directly connected with the oxygen can be replaced with the metal atoms when the acid is reacting with the base. The hydrogen atoms which are directly connected with the oxygen atom in the acid can be replaceable with the metal atoms or metal ions or ammonium ions when acid is reacting with the base. So in the case of H2SO4, basicity is 2. Not only H2SO4, for all oxo acids of sulfur base it is 2. For example, if you take H2SO3, right? S OH OH double bond O, right? This is 1, 2, 3, 4 bonds are there around the sulfur. O3H2, right? Here also base it is 2. You take H2S2O7, pyrosulfuric acid. S double single bond O, single bond S, double bond O, OH. Double bond O, OH. Again, the number of replaceable hydrogens is 2. Base it is 2. H2S2O8, S single bond O, single bond O, S double bond O, OH, double bond O, OH. That means in all oxo acids of sulfur, base it is same, that is a 2, right? But in the phosphorus oxo acids, the base CD will changes. One more important thing about the base CD is, if nothing is, equation is not given, they are asking about base CD, then it is 2 for the sulfuric acid. For example, if some equation is given, so how to find out the equivalent weight of H2SO4? Students, for example, they have asked what is the equivalent weight of sulfuric acid. Without any equation, if they are asking, equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by basicity. Basicity, right? Molecular weight of sulfuric acid is 98. For H2SO4 we are doing sulfuric acid. 98, basicity is 2, which is a 49. If it is asked along with the some equation, equation is provided and they are asking equivalent weight of sulfuric acid. Let us take one example. NaOH plus H2SO4 gives rise to NaHSO4 plus H2O. Here basicity is number of replaced hydrogens. Out of two hydrogens, only one hydrogen is replaced with the sodium metal, the Na plus, sodium metal atom, right, ion. Basicity here it is 1. The number of hydrogens replaced with the metal atom is 1 only. So here the equivalent weight of H2SO4 will be same as a molecular mass, right? So students, equivalent weight of an acid depends on reaction. Depends on reaction. If reaction is not given, that is 49. Equivalent weight of sulfuric acid is 49. If along with the some equation they are asking, then we need to check how many hydrogen atoms are replaced with the metal atoms, right? So here the equivalent weight is same as a molecular weight for the sulfuric acid. But in the case of oxo acids of phosphorus, if you take H3PO4, it has number of OH groups is 3. So base CD is 3 in this case, right? H3PO4, base CD is 3. If it is H3PO3, then base CD is 2. OH, only 2 OH groups are there, double bond OH, right? So basicity is 2 here. If it is H3PO2, basicity is 1. P, OH, double bond O, single bond H. Number of OH groups is same as a basicity for the acid. So here basicity is equal to 1, right? Next, let us discuss about the equivalent weight of a base. Students, next is equivalent weight of a base. Equivalent weight of a base is molecular weight divided by acidity. Equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by acidity. Acidity is same as number of OH groups in a base. Number of OH groups in a base. Right, students, for example, NaOH is taken, acidity is equal to 1, then equivalent weight is same as a molecular weight. If it is a CaOH twice, two OH groups are there, acidity is equal to 2. So the equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by acidity, that is known as valence factor or N factor. For the calcium hydroxide, equivalent weight is equal to molecular weight divided by 2. Right, students, in the next class we will continue our discussion about the equivalent concept with the equivalent weight of reducing and oxidizing agents. Thanks for watching.